Great. So hi, everybody. It's great to be here. Thanks all of you for coming. My name is Elad Benjamin. I'm the CEO of Zebra Medical Vision. And we're going to talk today about deep learning computer vision. You've heard it in many different industries. We're going to talk specifically about healthcare. And within the healthcare world, we're going to talk about medical imaging. In medicine, we've been expecting our physicians over the last few decades to become superhuman. The amount of knowledge they need to understand in a growing complex healthcare environment is becoming too much for any one individual to handle. And specifically in medical imaging, we're on an unsustainable course. There's more and more people that are joining the middle class and up around the world. They're spending healthcare out of pocket. They're creating more and more scans with more and more data. And there simply aren't enough radiologists that can read the amount of data and scans that are generated. And so one susceptible part of the healthcare environment is radiology. CTs, x-rays, MRIs, ultrasounds, et cetera. All of us depend on imaging in order to identify and diagnose many of the most common ailments that plague humanity today. So any kind of cancer, inflammation, fractures, and you know, almost anything. To diagnose it properly, you first need imaging. And in order to diagnose it properly, you need radiologists. And so just to give you a sense, in the US, for example, there's about 12 radiologists for every 100,000 people. In China, there's 3. India, there's 4. Some countries, there's even less. So the amount of physicians that are actually able to read all this data is simply not enough. And the supply-demand curve is just not going the right way. Too much demand and too little supply. And the amount of time and effort it takes to train enough radiologists, there just aren't enough universities to do it today. So that's the challenge that Zebra is facing. And a few years ago, in order to try and meet this challenge, we set out on a mission to enable high-end quality care for millions of patients worldwide by teaching software how to be a radiologist, by teaching software to automatically be able to receive a scan, an x-ray, a CT, a mammogram, and automatically analyze it and produce a report that is as close to a human radiologist and potentially sometimes even better than a human radiologist in detecting various findings that are needed. Now, how do we do it? You've heard about AI, deep learning. We are specifically focused in the visual space. Visual deep learning has come a long way in the last few years. We use neural networks, which is essentially a way of, I like to say we teach a computer like we teach a two-year-old. We give it thousands of examples of something until hopefully it learns what it is. Sometimes tens of thousands or millions of examples. And outside of healthcare, data sometimes is easy to come by. Inside healthcare, it's very hard to come across high-quality, large-scale data sets, millions and millions of patient scans, along with their associated clinical information that helps you actually teach a software architecture how to identify finding, how to identify lung cancer, how to identify bleeds in the brain, how to identify a punctured lung. You need a lot of data, you need a lot of nuanced data, and you need a lot of physicians to help teach the neural network what is and what isn't a valid clinical finding. And so outside of healthcare, this effort has been going on for the last 10, 15 years. There's a open source project called ImageNet. Millions and millions of photos are being tagged on a daily basis by people all around the world. You can all go to imagenet.org and contribute your own little tagging effort. But that's very difficult to do in medicine. None of us are trained. Most of us aren't trained. And we can't identify a lung nodule like we can identify a car or a motorcycle or a helmet. You need dedicated, specialized knowledge. And so within Zebra, when we started, we tried to create our equivalent of an ImageNet. This is the public ImageNet. You can go to imagenet.org, like I said. And at Zebra, we created our own Zebra database. Today, we have about 20 million patient scans comprising probably over, it says over 500 million individual images. It's probably more by now. And their associated clinical record. It's the largest privately held image database today in the world. And we've been using that database over the last 3.5, 4 years to teach software how to identify a growing number of clinical finding, relevant clinical findings. How to identify bleeds in the brain, how to identify diseased lungs, how to identify cysts or malignant masses in the breast in a mammogram, all with human level or near human level accuracy. And we provide these insights to radiologists, the physicians that actually read these cases, at the point of care so that they can create a more comprehensive, complete, and accurate report, ultimately leading to better care for their patients. Because we have this amount of data, the number of clinical tools that we're able to develop is growing exponentially. We're getting better and better at teaching the software, better and better at identifying how to create high-quality data sets, how to work with physicians. We've created a significant infrastructure that allows us to do so. And today, we've got the most comprehensive product in the market being sold in a number of different countries today. But when we set out, it wasn't just about the technology. It was really about trying to enable high-quality care and make it affordable for everybody. And so a few months ago, about 6 months ago, we publicly announced a business model that would provide all our analytics at $1 a scan. Until today, that's been unprecedented in the healthcare world. Usually, healthcare IT prices are opaque, convoluted, different pricing per country and use case, and we tried to create a scenario where anyone, anywhere can afford high-quality care. And we released this public business model about 6 months ago. Since then, we've had tremendous positive response from both developed healthcare economies and developing healthcare economies, which are looking to leapfrog over some of their gaps in care, countries that don't have enough physicians and that realize that that this is the only way, technology like this is the only way that they can provide better healthcare to their population. And so at the end of the day, you know, Zebra is now 3.5, 4 years old. We are continuing down that path of a very ambitious goal of trying to teach software to be a physician or part of the physician. We've gone down a few very significant steps down that road. We see the early adoption of the technology. We see customers benefiting from it every day. We've scanned over 1 million scans today, so 1 million patients have gotten the benefit of a number of different clinical findings. We see that we find in some cases 30% of our findings are not originally mentioned by the physician, so we're actually helping them find things that otherwise would have been missed. So thank you very much, and it's great to be here.